Okay, hi everyone. Today I'm going to talk about the Spatial Data Access Tool, enable visualization and access of geospatial data using OGC services and Googles. This is Yaxing. I'm a postdoctoral research associate from Oak Ridge National Lab, and I'm working together with Suresh, Bob, Bruce, and Tammy on this work. Before I start, let me ask a couple of questions. Do you spend quite some time on finding the data that can be used in your research using Google or some other tools? If you find some data, do you want to see the data instead of just reading some words about it? If the data is actually what you need, do you want to get the data in a form that can be used quickly and directly in your research with only minimum processing? The Spatial Data Access Tool I'm going to introduce today will help you to solve those problems. It makes it easier for you to find, visualize, and access biogeochemical and ecological data that is useful in environmental research. This work is funded by the ORNL DAC and the MASTER-DC projects. Let me first give a brief introduction to those two projects. The ORNL DAC, the Oak Ridge National Laboratory Distributed Active Archive Center, is an NASA-sponsored source for biogeochemical and ecological data and models useful in environmental research. It is a crucial link for the validation of biogeochemical inferences from remotely sensed data. The data archived in the ORNL DAC mainly falls into three categories: the field campaign data, land validation data, and the related regional and global data. There are over 800 datasets and about 220,000 data files, and the total volume is about 1.1 terabytes. The data files are stored in various formats, including ASCII, binary, NetCDF, and GeoTIFF. The modeling and synthesis schematic data center, the MASTER-DC, provides data management support for the North American Carbon Program project. Its goal is to provide data in the formats, resolutions, and the projections based on users' requirements. There are many carbon cycling models involved in the NACP project. So the data archived in MASTER-DC includes model inputs and output data. It also includes some observation data like forest and crop inventory, tower fluxes. There are some other related data like climate and ecoregion data archived. Data centers, especially for those handling earth science data, are facing challenges. The rapidly increasing archiving rate of geospatial data is only one issue. A bigger one is that geospatial data is heterogeneous in many aspects, including data format and metadata standard. The rapidly growing user community is another challenge. Users are getting more requirements on the data they need, and they expect more customized data than just the raw data. And nowadays, different data centers are using different mechanisms to publish and deliver data to users, and this introduces extra burdens to users if they need to access data from multiple centers. So this situation is getting more critical. With the earth science researches are getting more complex and expanding across more disciplines, data users need to find and visualize data efficiently. They need to access diverse data in ready-for-use formats and also in a standard way. So the data centers need to take new solutions to solve those problems and satisfy the data users. The ORNL DAC and the MASTER-DC have tapped into the benefits offered by Open Geospatial Consortium standards, web-enabled GIS tools, and virtual globe technology to accomplish this goal. So what is OGC? OGC, the short name for Open Geospatial Consortium, it is a nonprofit international voluntary consensus standards organization that is leading to the development of standards for geospatial and location-based services. The OGC standards cover almost all aspects of geospatial information, including the representation, management, processing, and application. The OGC standards we are using, the WMS and WCS, fall into the category of geospatial information management. The OGC Web Coverage Service, WCS, defines a standard interface that enables customizable access to geospatial coverage data. A coverage means a phenomena that covers a geographic area, such as satellite images and digital elevation model data. The OGC Web Map Service, the WMS, defines a standard interface that enables the visualization of geospatial data, and this including both the coverage and features. This standardization of the data visualization and access promotes the geospatial information interoperability, which benefits both the data centers and the data users. Based on Map Server, we developed and deployed the OGC WCS and WMS servers. The ORNL WCS server is compatible with OGC WCS standard version 1.0.0. It provides features for customized geospatial coverage data access, like spatial, temporal, band subsetting, reprojection, resampling, and reformatting. Popular data formats are supported, including GeoTIFF, ArcInfo, ASCII Grid, NetCDF, NITF, and Erdos Imagine. The ORNL WMS server is compatible with OGC WMS standard version 1.1.1. Besides those features provided in WCS server, it also supports both automatic and manual color scheme definition. It can render images in PNG, JPEG, and GIF format. The ORNL WCS and WMS servers are mainly machine-oriented. In order to bring the benefits of those servers to the end users, we developed the Spatial Data Access Tool, and the URL is listed here. The SDAT tool is a web application that enables users to find, visualize, and access geospatial data in user-specified temporal, spatial extent resolution, format, and projection. It provides a WMS-driven interactive map widget for data visualization and WCS-based options for customizable data access. Within Spatial Data Access Tool, geospatial data is organized in two levels, the dataset level and the data file level. As of today, there are 65 datasets available through the ORNL OGC servers and the Spatial Data Access Tool. Those datasets fall into a couple of major categories, including land cover, elevation, soil, climate, and ecoregion. The main page of the Spatial Data Access Tool, as shown on the left image, provides a list of all the available datasets, their preview images, a keyword search box, and links to metadata pages and KMZ files, which I will talk about later. Following the links provided from the main page, users can get to another page listing all the files contained in a specific dataset, along with some brief file-level metadata information. The file-level interface provides rich file-level metadata information on the top of the page. For example, the projection definition in OGC well-known text format. In the middle of this page is an open layers-based interactive map widget. Within this map widget, users can pan, zoom in, or zoom out the map. It also supports on-the-fly map reprojection. If a user selects a different projection from the list, the map will be displayed in that particular projection as shown on this image. On the bottom of the page are those WCS-based options for customizable coverage data access. The Spatial Data Access Tool is web-based. It brings data visualization and access functions from local computers to the World Wide Web. The emerging virtual globe technology, like Google's, builds a virtual world on top of the World Wide Web. We can call that the Web Wide World. It brings users a new and higher level platform and many more benefits for geospatial data visualization and delivery. We seized this great opportunity and used the ASIP WMS to KML converter to prepare a KMZ file for each dataset for users to visualize the data in Google Earth. Following the visualized in Google Earth links, users can access to those KMZ files from the Spatial Data Access Tool. All the maps and corresponding legend images displayed in Google Earth are dynamically created by the ORNL WMS server. A new map will be retrieved and displayed in Google Earth every time the user touches the globe. In the next couple of slides, I will introduce those benefits that users can get from using Google Earth. Google Earth provides rich and valuable background maps, such as high-resolution satellite images, roads, landmarks, and borders. The value of scientific data increases the more you can link it to information that the user is already familiar with and considers important. So we should take this opportunity to present our geospatial data in a way that users can easily tie to other data sources. For example, on this screen, we overlay the national land cover data, which is available through the Spatial Data Access Tool, with those rich information provided within Google Earth around the Bay Area. The red color represents the developed urban area, and the brown color, which is near the top right corner of this image, represents the croplands. So in this manner, users can easily have a sense of those different land types around the Bay Area. Google Earth also provides powerful address and keyword-based locating capability. Say, what if the user wants to see a data near Yosemite? It is easy to locate the Yosemite National Park within Google Earth. And Google Earth provides excellent data visualization capability. It is globe-based and simulates the real Earth. Users can visualize the data from arbitrary angle of view. They can even virtually fly within Google Earth. It supports three-dimensional objects and a terrain surface elevation. And this image shows how the Google Earth overlays the national land cover data onto the terrain surface in the Yosemite National Park. Within Google Earth, users can overlay any map from any dataset for intercomparison. Let's compare the land cover patterns in the Three Gorges Dam area in China between 2001 and 2007. The Three Gorges Dam, as marked by the red balloon on this image, is the world's largest hydroelectric dam. The first map shows the land cover map for 2001, and the second image shows the land cover map for 2007. By comparing those two images, we can see the increase of water area and the reduce of croplands, and some woody savannas were replaced by mixed forests. From those changes, we can think that the Three Gorges Dam does have impact on the environment, and there was residency relocation activity. One may not be able to do accurate analysis within Google Earth, but a good visualization tool like Google Earth is critical for the generating of scientific hypotheses and questions that one can go on to test. It is part of getting an intuitive grasp of the problem. It is super convenient to run time series animation within Google Earth. And this video shows the monthly 1 degree resolution CO2 flux from 1998 to 2006 displayed within Google Earth. And this data was simulated by the simple biosphere model version 3. Negative values, as denoted by the blue colors, represent carbon uptake into the ecosystem. And the positive values, as denoted by the red colors, represent the carbon release from the ecosystem. You can see the blue color region moves to the north during summer and moves to the south during winter, which is a reflection of the seasonal cycle of the CO2 flux. Since version 5, the information window of Google Earth supports JavaScript and iframe. This means we can put rich and well-formatted descriptive information about the data layer into Google Earth. We can even embed the spatial data access tool inside Google Earth so that users can visualize the data in Google Earth and access the data through spatial data access tool without leaving Google Earth. And this video shows how users can launch and use the spatial data access tool from within Google Earth. From the information window, users can see the rich file level metadata information. He can preview the map of the data and use some tool to select an area and zoom into that particular area. He can use some other tool to select a region for spatial subsetting and then go ahead to change the spatial resolution or manually set the region for spatial subsetting. He can do something else, like select a particular data format from the list of all available data formats, and then go ahead to access this customized data. This integration of spatial data access tool and Google Earth provides users more convenience for the data visualization and access. And here comes the summary and future work. The ORNL deck and MustDC are rich sources for biogeochemical and ecological data useful in environmental research. The ORNL OGC servers and the spatial data access tool provide efficient and customizable visualization and access to geospatial data in a standard way. Google Earth serves as a new platform and brings many more benefits for geospatial data visualization and delivery. I hope the ORNL OGC servers, the spatial data access tool, and Google Earth provide positive answers to those questions I raised before this presentation. In the future, we are going to incorporate more OGC standards, such as the Web Feature Service, WFS, which enables the customizable access to geospatial feature data. Thank you. Any questions?